Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In this program of the beautiful names of Allah, today we are going to take first Al-Mu'izz and then Al-Mudhil. Al-Mu'izz, which is coming from Izzah, the honorer who gives esteem to whom he likes. And Al-Mudhil is going to be the opposite of that, the dishonorer, the one who gives humiliation. But let us first explain Al-Mu'izz. And we have said when we were explaining about Al-Aziz, that this word Al-Aziz, which is coming from Azza, Ya'izzu or Ya'azzu or Ya'uzzu, because of that variance, it got three implications, three meanings. The first is Al-Aziz, the one who got none to compare with him, none similar unto him, none like him. And the second meaning, that he is the dominant, nobody can dominate him. And the third, that he is strong, so strong that nobody can frustrate him. So all these three meanings are contained in this word Al-Mu'izz. He is Allah who can give Al-Izzah. He can give the dominance. He can give the power. That is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, as it is in Surah Al-Imran, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُظِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Say, O Allah, the owner of the kingdom, you give the kingdom to whom you like. You take away the kingdom from whom you like. You give honor and dignity to whom you like. And you humiliate whom you like. بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ. In your hand is all good. إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And you are able upon each and everything. And in the very same way, مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْعُزَّةَ فَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ جَمِيعًا. And the person who wants real dignity and honor, then he should know that to Allah belongs the dignity and honor. He is the source of dignity and honor. If you want it, then seek it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you that dignity and honor, Al-Izzah, then spend it. Then spend it to make this deen a dominant one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that person who gives that honor to his deen. Man a'azza deenahu. The person who is giving that izzah, that dignity to the deen itself by supporting it, by preaching it, by conveying it to other people with all the power and the abilities which he got, then of course if you support the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is going to support you as well. Now there is saying of the leader of Munafiqeen al-Madina, لَإِن رَجَعْنَا إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ لَيُخْرِجَنَّ الْأَعَزُّ مِنْهَا الْأَذَلُ. He said, though he was just behaving like a Muslim, but he was a hypocrite, a munafiq. And he said, when we will come back to Medina, the person who is honorable is going to expel the person who is humiliated. And by honorable, he meant himself. And by humiliated, he meant the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the answer comes from Allah. وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَكِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Let him know that the dignity and honor, it belongs to Allah and to the Prophet, his Prophet, and to the believers. But these munafiqeen people, hypocrites, they don't know, they don't realize. They think that because they are enjoying some wealth and power and some supporting and some following, this is why they got this dignity. But they don't realize that the real dignity lies in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can deprive you at any moment from that honor which you think you got. Because the honor lies in the hand of Allah. There is a very good saying of Ali ibn Husayn, the son of Al-Husayn ibn Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Very good saying. He said, "Man arada izzan bila ashiratin, wa haybatan bila sultanin, wa ghinan bila malin, falyakhruj min zullil ma'siyah ila izzit ta'ah." The person who wants the honor without a tribe, because some people in the olden days, because if you got a very big tribe, you are more honorable in the eyes of the people. So the person who wants that dignity, that honor without a tribe supporting him, وَهَيْبَةً بِلَا سُلْطَانٍ, and he wants that without authority, the people should have a very great respect for him. And وَغِنًا بِلَا مَالٍ, and he wants a wealth but without money, any wealth of another type of nature, without money, فَلْيَخْرُجْ مِنْ ذُلِّ الْمَعْصِيَةِ إِلَىٰ عِزِّ الطَّاعَةِ, then he should come out. He himself should come out from the humiliation of disobedience, humiliation of the sins, to the dignity of obedience. And you will get it. So what he is trying to say that once you leave the sins and you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you follow the commandments of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will have that honor. Without a tribe, you would have that respect from the people, without a big authority, and you have that istighna, that you are independent, without getting a lot of money.